Dr. Scholz, can you explain what BPH is? So that's an enlarged prostate, but how does that really affect a man in his everyday day-to-day?
Actually, it often doesn't affect men very much. We have a lot of men that come in because their PSA is running high, and they have no idea they have an enlarged prostate. You'd think that every urinary difficulty that people have is blamed on big prostates, and of course, how ridiculous that is, because women can have urinary difficulties and they don't even have prostates. So the issue comes down to sometimes when the prostate gets large, it can compress the urinary passage that goes from the bladder out the penis and cause blockage, slow flow, and sometimes the prostate gets so large that it starts pushing into the bladder and the residual bladder capacity is reduced. So that means that men are going to go to the bathroom more frequently than they would normally because their bladder isn't as big because it's being replaced by a large prostate. So these are just some of the things that large prostates are known to do, but most men don't have any symptoms at all. They have a big prostate, they may run a high PSA, but they don't really have any difficulties.
So when we say enlarged prostate, the normal average man's prostate size is 40 cc's. What would be considered a large prostate?
Well, actually, young men have 20 cc prostates. So as guys get older, almost everyone's prostate starts getting bigger. And when you get to about 60, 65, which is the age that I start seeing men for prostate cancer, by then the prostate gland has gotten to about 40 cc's. But they can be as large as 1 to 200 cc's in some men. And of course, in my practice, I see that a lot because those are the gentlemen that end up getting high PSAs, prostate biopsies, and being diagnosed with prostate cancer. So we have a lot of men who have enlarged prostates. I'd say the typical amount of enlargement beyond the average 40 cc's is probably in the 60 to 80 cc range.
Are there a certain group of men who would be more susceptible to BPH, or is that not known?
Yeah, we don't really know the cause. It probably is partly familial. There's been some suspicion that low-grade infections cause some sort of a reaction and the prostate gets bigger. That's purely speculative. And the cause of BPH is really not well understood.
So we get a lot of questions on Helpline where men may have BPH and may be diagnosed with that, but they're concerned that they have prostate cancer because of their PSA levels. So can you explain how men can differentiate that with their doctor?
Yeah, so PSA is a non-specific test. It can be high from prostate cancer, BPH, prostatitis. And we look at the size of the gland, as we've been talking about, and divide that by 10. And that tells you what you would expect the PSA to be in a normal man who doesn't have prostate cancer. So a man with a 60 cc prostate may have a PSA of around 6, and we would consider that normal. That's not an elevated PSA, even though when you look at the lab report, it says if it's above 4, that you have a high PSA. That high PSA is just a general rule of thumb because it's not incorporating how big the prostate is.
In regards to prostate cancer, if a man is diagnosed with prostate cancer, but he also has an enlarged prostate, are there any treatments that will not be available to him because the prostate is so large?
Yeah, so there's advantages and disadvantages from a prostate cancer point of view. If you have a very large prostate, it becomes somewhat more tricky to do surgery or radiation because you're treating a much larger area. On the other hand, if someone is thinking of one of these newer investigational focal treatments, it's actually helpful to have a big prostate. There's more margin for error. If you're going to try and take out a certain section of a small prostate, you may end up taking out the whole prostate. And the goal with these focal treatments is to try and help men not lose their sexual function. So the men with big prostates have an advantage in that regard. If they're thinking of doing focal therapy.
So do men who have enlarged prostates, are they more predisposed to having prostate cancer?
Well, because their PSAs run high, they end up getting more prostate biopsies. And as we've talked about in other videos, men have, the more you biopsy them, the more prostate cancer you find. The low-risk prostate cancers are everywhere in the male population. So men with big prostates get diagnosed more frequently. It doesn't mean that having a big prostate leads to cancer. It just leads to the diagnosis of cancer. The types of cancers that they get on these biopsies that are, these we'll call them unnecessary biopsies, are low grade. And so when you look at the overall outcome from cancers in general in men that have been diagnosed with prostate cancer, the men with big prostates do better. And people suspect it's because they're just finding these low grade cancers and that you have a larger pool of favorable cancers. And so the statistics look better. There have been others that have hypothesized that the big prostate has an inhibitory effect on cancer in general. And this is all speculation. No one really knows the answer. But it's not a disadvantage to have a big prostate when you're dealing with prostate cancer. It's probably an advantage.
Thanks for watching. If you would like more information about prostate cancer or any of the topics we talked about today, you can go ahead and visit our website, PCRI.org. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel. This will keep you updated on all of our new videos, and give us a thumbs up if you liked today's video. We hope you have a great week.